guys, it's Jason from California. Today is November 26th, 2008, the day before Thanksgiving. And today is my weigh-in day. Yes, the day before Thanksgiving. Saved. I'll just get to the weigh-in, because that's generally what I do. My weigh-in today was 201.8, which is a loss of exactly 2 pounds from last week. No, you can stop clapping. I was shocked when I stepped on the scale, actually, because it has not been the easiest week, and, gosh. Well, as you guys know, I have this bet with Shanti that whoever loses the highest weight loss percentage before the other person meets the other person, which will be December 17th, correct me if I'm wrong, Shanti, the loser gives the winner $25. So, to update you guys on my weight loss percentage for that contest, my weight loss percent will be 1% at this point. So I still have a little bit of time left. I'm really happy with that. So, yeah. I said I was going to be doing a video about the things that make me happy and other than eating. And I did do a lot of stuff this week. I started making little video clips here and there, but then I realized a lot of these things that I'm doing are leading to more eating. And it's just because a couple of them were in LA. So, yeah, that's why. But I did get to see Wicked this week, which was disappointing. Wasn't the best play I've ever seen. I'm happy I saw it, finally, to get all the hype out of my head. CD is much better than the play. Play just kind of is incoherent mess. It is an incoherent mess. But that's okay. It was a good try. Then for Robert's birthday, which just passed, I took him to LA as well to see Sarah Silverman, which also was disappointment. She was using all of her material from her Jesus is Magic movie, which was 3 years ago. You think the woman could come up with some new material by then. I don't know why, but it was at least a good time to, get out and get to a comedy club and do something different. And then I made a video about like how I play video games and how I look at YouTube videos. And suffice it to say, I do have a lot of things I enjoy doing, and I'm excited about a lot of things. I just need to not get so excited that I go out to eat afterwards. Which I did a good job of, because as soon as I made that bet with Shanti, I actually didn't do anything off plan. I'm very happy with that. thank you guys for all your positive comments on my video about the protests in California. I've had that footage for so long, but I haven't been able to get it up. Because I really wanted to do something really artistic and like put it to a song and really like make it impactful, but I looked at the footage afterwards and I was like, I think this can speak for itself. So it did. On a similar note, I got something in the mail a couple days ago, and I meant to share it with you guys, but I didn't. It's this. Which, I don't know if you guys know what that is, but it is a marriage certificate for the state of California. So, I have a marriage certificate saying that Robert and I are now married. However, it's confusing because the bill says that only marriages between a man and a woman will be valid or recognized in the state of California. So, is this valid? I don't know. If it is, great, but it's also very bittersweet because it's like, great, well, I'm married, but other people can't get married. And that doesn't feel right. But then if I'm not married, it's like I'm just part of that minority again, which I'm still part of the minority. Either way, it just feels wrong still. I mean, yeah, I'm married, but what does that mean? What do I get? So I was actually, I'm going to be looking up some of the thousands and thousands of rights that married people get. See if I can find at least one that I can test and go test it. Because I want to see if people will let me do it. Because I really don't think anyone in California knows what the hell is going on right now. As far as if I'm legally married or if I'm not, it just all needs to change, because honestly, we're taking away human rights, and we're not protecting the damn children at all. I mean, I could still go out in front of an elementary school and hand out pamphlets about what gay people are to your children. I'm not going to do that, because I think that children aren't idiots, okay? And for all the people out there that voted yes on Prop 8 to protect the children from what gay people are, how fucking stupid do you think your kids actually are? Do you know your kids watch TV? Do you know your kids talk? Do you know your kids gossip? Do you know your kids have lives? I mean, they know what gay people are. And it's not like it's like we're mass murderers or like child rapists or anything. We're leaving that to the Catholic Church. I'm kidding. I'm kidding. But still. Come on, people. Kids are not stupid. And you gotta give them more credit than that. When I was a kid, I was very conniving. My parents can attest to that. And I'm sure that the kids of today are even more conniving than I was, okay? They know how to use a lot of electronic stuff that I don't even understand, and I'm trying my best to keep up on it. But let's give the kids credit. I mean, kids know what homosexual means. They're not stupid. And they already are homosexual or not homosexual because you're born that way. Right? Well, that's the majority thinking anyway. I'll keep my opinion to myself, because I don't believe either way. Well, I'll say what my opinion is. I don't believe sexuality exists. I believe that if love and passion are strong enough in any instance, anyone can fall in love with anyone, and a sexual attraction is able to develop if you really feel that deeply for a person. So there's my thought. Sexuality does not exist, and it's all just a big black and white, we need to put a label on this, a label on this, just so we can identify it. Which is just the human, it's just the human way. I mean, we have to. Unfortunately, I'm a very gray area person, whereas most people are black and white. But anyway, I'm very close to 200 and getting below 200. I'm very excited. And even if I don't win the bet with Shanti, this is definitely helping me out, because I only went to the gym once this week, and it was last night, which I did not expect to lose weight today. That's why I'm like shocked. Usually after I go to the gym, I gain weight. I was there for about an hour and a half, just kicking my ass, so. The gym is my friend, and we're going to keep moving forward. I'm cooking Thanksgiving dinner tomorrow, so I will update you guys on that, and the video should be up by Friday night, because I'm cooking the entire Thanksgiving, including the dessert, which is a first. I'm going to turn it into a healthy Jenny Craig Thanksgiving, using recipes and not high fructose corn syrup, so don't worry, Shanti, no high fructose corn syrup is going to be in the turkey. But yeah, so that's all for my update. I will see you guys next week, and probably Friday for the Thanksgiving Day update. And yeah, so please don't forget to rate, subscribe, and favorites, and all that good stuff. And I will see you later. Bye.